Hello everyone and welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 3. Last time we got the sneak bobblehead and the unarmed bobblehead from the Yaoguai tunnels in Rockopolis. Today we're going to start in Girdershade and make our way down to the Dunwich building for the melee weapons bobblehead. Let's get started. Here we are in Girdershade, a two-home settlement of sorts. That's Sierra Petrovita's home. I'm gonna go there second. Let's go across the way and check out Ronald Blarin's home. Assuming he's not around. All his stuff is owned. And I don't particularly feel the need to steal it. Now let's head into Sierra Petrovita's house.
Sierra Petrovita's the name. Good to see a new face in Girdershade. I take it you're here to check out my Nuka-Cola collection and take the tour.
Nuka-Cola collection? Wow!
I have one of the best Nuka-Cola collection in the Capital Wasteland. Heck, I've won the Nuka-Cola Fan Club Collection Award for the last 10 years in a row.
There's a Nuka-Cola Fan Club?
Yep, I'm the president, the recording secretary, and the treasurer. Once a year, we gather here in Girdershade to have a cook-off using Nuka-Cola and the recipe. Last year, I won with my poached roach and Nuka sauce. Delicious.
Wait a minute, how many members are in your club?
Well, only two right now, me and Ronald. But membership is open to the public. You can join if you like.
Who's Ronald?
Ronald? Oh, I'm sorry. I figured you met him already. He usually chats with people who enter Girdershade. He's my neighbor and my protector, as he calls it. Imagine if some nasty raider wanted to take my stuff. He'd show them a thing or two. He's such a sweetie. You should talk to him.
Tell me more about this Ronald guy.
He's a darling, always watching out for me, and more importantly, keeping the collection safe. Like once, there were these raiders that came by. There were three of them, and their leader was named, like, Lugnut or something.
Sierra?
So they, like, kicked in Ronald's door, and he was like, blam, with his gun, and one of them got all splattered. Then the other one tried to, like, hit him all in his head with some club. And Ronald was so cool how he dodged it and shot the guy in the face. Then the Lugnut guy was in Ronald's face with the
"I'll kick your ass"
stuff. And Ronald was like, hell no. And he punched the...
Sierra, please, I get it. He's tough.
Oh, sorry. I get carried away sometimes. Well, you should definitely talk to Ronald. I bet he'd like to meet you. He's such a sweetheart.
Yeah, he sounds great. So you mentioned a tour or something?
I sure did. Want to take it now? How can you resist? This stuff is so cool.
Yes, of course.
Well, come on then. Let me show you around. But no free Nuka-Cola until the end of the tour.
Quest added.
When Nuka-Cola was invented by John Caleb Braverton in 2044, it quickly became the world's most popular soft drink.
The Nuka-Cola Challenge. First up, take Sierra's Nuka-Cola tour.
The Wonder Drink soon drew a dedicated following, which prompted the Nuka-Cola Corporation to release many promotional items like these. By 2067, a Nuka-Cola machine such as this rare, pristine model could be found on almost every street in America. Even in today's crazy world, Nuka-Cola is still the number one choice of refreshment among Armageddon survivors. as promised, here's a little pick-me-up. An ice-cold Nuka-Cola.
Completed.
Just look at the frost on the bottle. So cold and delicious.
Speak to Sierra Petrovna.
Pardon me. I tend to lose myself when I hold on to a Nuka-Cola. Before I get to the little proposition I have for you, let me tell you a little bit about Nuka-Cola Quantum.
Ice-cold Nuka-Cola added. Completed. Speak to Sierra Petrovna. Quantum. Never heard of it before.
Well, right before the bombs fell, the good folks at Nuka-Cola developed what they hoped was an improvement on the original formula. Calling it Nuka-Cola Quantum, it was said to have twice the calories, twice the carbohydrates, twice the caffeine, and twice the taste!
So what went wrong?
Well, the flavor certainly wasn't the issue. The public was just split on the unique feature of the Quantum's appearance. You see, to make it stand out on store shelves and to give it that extra kick, the formula called for a mild isotope. The effect was a drink that not only boosted your energy, but also glowed with a bright blue light.
Wait, did you say it has an isotope in it? As in, it's radioactive?
Oh no, only ever so mildly. No ill effects were ever recorded. Well, it does have the unique property of making your pee glow.
Glowing pee? That sounds like dangerous stuff.
Oh no, not at all. Nuka-Cola Quantum was made under the supervision of the Food and Drug Association. They would never let harmful products end up in stores.
What's your interest in all this?
I love the stuff! I can't get enough of it! I thought I was hooked on regular Nuka-Cola, but the Quantum beats it by a long shot. I've got to have more!
So that's where I come in, I guess.
That's right. You bring me Nuka-Cola Quantum, and I pay you. Handsomely, I might add. For every bottle you bring me, I pay you some caps. You know, for expenses. But if you're super cool and find like enough bottles to fill my Nuka-Cola machine, 30 in all, I've got a super secret cool prize for you.
Come on, Sierra. No secrets between friends.
Nope, I'm not telling. It's a really cool surprise, though. You're gonna love it. I promise.
Doesn't really change anything. She just tells you that the special prize is a Nuka grenade schematic. Okay, Sierra, you've got a deal.
Oh, goody! I can taste the Quantum already. Good luck to you, sweetie.
Matt Marker added, recover 30 bottles of Nuka-Cola Quantum and bring them to Sierra Petrovna. Is there anything else interesting to see near Girdershade?
Well, to the east, there are some nasty raiders in Evergreen Mills. I'd stay away from there if I were you. Luckily, we're kind of hidden here under the old highway, so no one bothers us.
What do you know about Nuka-Cola Quantum?
Well, besides what I've already told you, not much. They were working on a way to prevent the glow from remaining once it passed through a person's system, but it was never perfected. I heard that the stuff they used to make it glow and give it that kick has a shelf life of over 1,000 years. Should make the bottles easier to spot.
What exactly does a bottle of Quantum look like?
Well, the bottles are glass just like regular Nuka-Cola, except the glass is clear. That way the glowy stuff inside shows through. You'll know it when you see it.
What happens when you drink a Nuka-Cola Quantum?
Oh my! It's like a tidal wave of flavor washing all over your body!
Your head spins, but everything is clear at the same time! It's quite a rush!
You seem kind of addicted to the stuff. Is it safe to drink?
Addicted? Why would you say that? I can stop drinking it any time I want. That's so silly to think I would get hooked on the most delicious soft drink ever devised by man.
Let me ask you about something else.
Okay, shoot!
Do you even have a clue as to where I can start looking?
In fact, I do! Surprised you, didn't I? Your best bet would be to find the ruins of the DC Nuka-Cola bottling facility. Find the shipping manifests inside. With them in hand, you should have a good clue as to where the Quantum was delivered. While you're there, you may even be able to find some bottles of Quantum.
What do you know about the Nuka-Cola bottling facility?
Well, the DC facility was like their main factory just before the bombs fell. All the research they did was performed there. It was the only facility to ever produce Quantum. They were in a test market mode, and they would have expanded production if the drink caught on. Too bad they didn't. Otherwise, Quantum would be as plentiful as regular Nuka-Cola.
I have to go now.
I can't wait.
Alright, when we head outside, Ronald Laren is gonna chat with us.
Hey, pal. What were you doing in Sierra's place?
I was checking out Sierra's Nuka-Cola collection.
That better be all you were checking out. I don't like guys messing with my woman.
She never said anything about you two being together.
Well, that's likely because it's none of anyone's business but ours. She's one hot lady, though, am I right?
What are you driving at?
Wow, you are as naive as you look. How do I put it? I'd love to do the horizontal bop with her, you know, plow her bean field. Come on, kid.
Can't say I blame you.
Now you're speaking my language. Well, only problem is she won't give it up for me. That's where you come into the picture.
Just what is it you need me to do?
I know she's asked you to find her some Nuka-Cola Quantum. Heck, she asks everyone that wanders through here. What I'm proposing is you still look for the drinks, but instead of bringing it to her, you bring it to me. She'll be so impressed that I got all the Nuka-Cola for her, she'll melt in my arms like butter. I pay you the same she was going to pay, and everyone's happy.
How about you pay me double for each Quantum bottle?
No, I don't think so. Take what you can get.
Sorry, I'm not interested in your offer.
Well, look. Don't answer me now. Just keep it in mind. If you find some, and you've had a change of heart, I'll still buy them. Oh, and I wouldn't bother running back to Sierra and warning her. She won't even understand what you're talking about. She may be a hottie, but she's a bit vacant in the smarts department.
If you're feeling evil, optional, recover 30 bottles of Nuka-Cola Quantum and bring them to Ronald Laren. If you're feeling evil, you can kill him because he has a unique sawed-off shotgun called the Kneecapper. It does 50% more damage than a standard sawed-off shotgun. I'm not going to kill him for it because even the unique one is inferior to a standard combat shotgun in pretty much every way. That's it for Girdershade for now. We'll come back. Whoa. Something just blew up somewhere. Debris landed all the way over here. Anyway. I'll get 30 bottles of Nuka-Cola Quantum well before I want to actually come back here. Actually, there's a good reason for it. There's a unique item you can get in and around the Nuka-Cola plant, but it only works, or you can only get it if the quest is still active. So although I'll probably find my 30th bottle well before then, I don't want to end the quest until I actually go to the bottling facility. There we go. Alright, let's head east from here. And just a hair south. This bombed out house. Cherry bomb and a hockey mask. I didn't know this was up here. Unmarked all by itself. Anything inside? No. I think this is our first giant rad scorpion. It is. Let's fire lance him. Oh. Let me dart gun him first to slow him down. Now let's fire lance him. Behold the power. A mole rat. All right. There we go. 4 poison glands for killing a giant radscorp. Always nice. Let's make sure this guy is fully loaded. Oh, he is. Good. And let's keep going east. You can see the location marker there. Just a teeny little landmark. Nothing fancy. Here's Jocko's Poppin' Gas Stop. I think I got 2 mole rats and a regular rad scorpion. Drink here, just fix up that tiny bit of damage I took. Anyway, like most of the small locations, there's not a whole lot to find here. It's worth taking a look around. We've got a tin can, a vending machine with 2 Nuka-Colas in it. Nothing around back, so let's go inside. Tin can. There's a stim pack in that little pot. Tin can. Empty. Tin can. Those are empty. Nothing in there. Nothing in those metal boxes. Couple of caps. Pack of cigarettes. Carton of cigarettes. Nikola Tesla and you. Energy weapons up by 2 to 34. Scotch. A bottle cap mine. Paint gun. Wonder glue. Turpentine. Schematics bottle cap mine. Your schematic has been improved. Schematics bottle cap mine V2. This schematic now makes 2 mines. And Nuka-Cola Quantum and Mentats. Productive little stop, I have to say. See the radio tower up there? Let's get up to it. It's a damaged garden gnome for some reason. More explosions. I see a Yowtai. Punched to death, like so many before him. And there's my radio tower. Got another hostel nearby. Better deal with that first. I just saw some whiskey. Clip into the ground. An awful waste of resources. There's some kind of random encounter happening in there. Empty whiskey bottle, large whiskey bottle, whatever. Whatever that hostel is. Uh-oh. Oh! I knew that was about to happen. Alright. Let's deal with the radio tower first. Turn it on. Radio signal Sierra Victor. This is just Morse code. I don't know what's being said. Go down to ground level and kill that rad scorpion. And let me see if I can figure out what that, random encounter was. I saw that wastelander take off running. Looks like there was a fight. Or an explosion of some sort. That one died. And another one ran off. Doesn't concern me. Let's get back up to the radio tower. I'll show you what does concern me. Well, that's just an enclave I bought. First things first, I want to get that whiskey that clipped in, if I can. So. Silly. OCD. Maybe. I hate to be cheated out of anything because of glitches. I don't think that's so irrational. Alright. Cross over the collapsed tower. Over to here. And we can hop in the sewer entrance to the drainage chamber. Be careful, there are some serious traps in here. Disarm the pressure plate. Disarm the pressure plate. We really need to be careful here. Didn't work. There's a grenade bouquet just on the other side of this. Given your understanding of explosives, it could be possible to disarm the grenade bouquet and collect the grenades. You've successfully disarmed the grenade bouquet and received 3 grenades. Very nice. 3 frag grenades added. Alright. Go over here. Disarm 2 frag mines. Head over here, this door, note the little spinning thing on the computer, do not activate it from the front, activate the rear panel. Your explosive skill is not high enough to disarm the trap, explosives 45 or higher required. Well, let's just leave it be then. Wouldn't want it to explode. Assault rifle in crummy shape, a fission battery, jet, steam gauge assembly, 3 purified waters, 2 ammo boxes, one of them with an easy lock. Spring that open. Tire iron, whoop-dee-doo. Frag mine, toolbox, paint gun, and a couple of plungers, which are useless. There's a dead guy. A couple of crutches. Looks like he was working on another trap. There's some scrap metal. 2 fission batteries, conductor, steam gauge assembly, sensor module, 3 cherry bombs, 2 frag mines, mini nuke, and a copy of Duck and Cover. Explosives increased by 2 to 35. Awesome. Bottle cap mine, turpentine, Abraxo cleaner, a couple of railway spikes, and that's it for this place. Let's get up out of the drainage chamber now at this unmarked radio tower. From here, let's head west. Uh-oh. Shoot, 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 shoot. Come on. Damn it, damn it, damn it. Stay high long enough. Yes. Where we can see a location marker. Well, first we'll kill another rad scorpion. And easy. Anyway, we'll head over here to the west. Toward a location that is marked, another power station. This one's VAPL-66. There's the power substation. We can open the gates, but there's nothing in here. Oh, let's go into the substation. Note that this is a raider lair. Motorcycle handbrake, medical brace, motorcycle gas tank, a mini nuke, a dart inside the desk, surgical tubing, a copy of Dean's Electronics, repair increased by 2 to 62, awesome, 2 paint guns, sugar bombs, psycho, 2 medex, a leather belt, mentats, 2 stim packs, lawnmower blade, a leaf blower, wonder glue, paint gun, scrap metal sensor module, 2 more lawnmower blades, paint gun, scrap metal. And when we leave, the raiders are going to show up and attack us. Supposed to, anyway. Where are the raiders at? Huh. There's no raiders. Okay. Works for me. No skin off my nose. Let's go offload because we're pretty close to our carry weight limit. Maybe they'll show up when I fast travel back. Who knows?
Welcome home.
Braxo, cherry bombs, conductor, crutch, fishing battery, lawnmower blade, leaf blower, leather belt, medical brace, gas tank, handbrake, 6 paint guns, 8 poison glands, 2 sensor modules, 2 steam gauge assemblies, surgical tubing, 14 tin cans, 2 turpentine, 2 wonder glue, 2 Nuka-Cola, and an ice cold Nuka-Cola. Alrighty.
Sir?
Nothing unique. I do have several explosives, 2 bottle cap mines, 3 frag grenades, 3 frag mines. I tell you what, I'm gonna quit carrying fire lance around. I don't have enough ammo for it to really justify it. And if it's not one-shotting the big things, I consider myself too weak to use it. Well, there we go. Let's put away the scrap metal, our Nuka-Cola Quantum, purified water, sugar bombs. Make sure I'm all healed up. Let's wait 10 hours. So Moira's open.
All of us here thank you for... It's the best.
Certainly, thank you. I'm trying to think if there's anything
else. So are they intelligent?
I need to spend caps on, like, in the entire game. Repairs, yes. I need to invest in the caravans. Well, the answer is yes. It's definitely still worth it to collect things to sell. That's what I was
good
trying
hunting.
To decide. Prepare that stuff for me, if you would.
I got my...
Let's pop back to BAPL-66 power station. See if those raiders have spawned in. Not yet. There's a gas tank and handbrake I missed. Let me try popping in and out one more time, just see if that triggers them. If not, I'm gonna say, screw it, and get on with my life. Alright, I'm gonna equip my dart gun now. I'm gonna head south to the F. Scott Key Trail and Campground. It's marked. It's that marker near the power station off to the southwest. We're going to be greeted by our first Deathclaw. It is vital to have a dart gun before you try to tangle with a Deathclaw. Their attacks are incredibly powerful, and they completely ignore your damage resistance. They are shockingly fast, and they can do a leaping attack, which can close the distance between you from an astonishing distance. All that's neutralized if you shoot them with the dart gun and cripple their legs. So it's a pretty important thing to have. Got some Brahmin. Just chillin'. Alright, Brahmin, keep doing your thing. Looks like I'm gonna have to fight a mole rat and maybe a Protectron. These guys have likely been shredded by that Deathqual. I think is that red hash mark I can see. That's the Dunwich building, by the way. We're pretty close to our actual destination for this segment. There he is. Deathclaw. In all his glory. Pick up these tin cans. Just keep an eye on him. I think he's spotted me. More tin cans. A copy of Duck and Cover. Explosives increased by 2 to 37. That's awesome. Three more tin cans. It's just a standard little Yaogwai. Didn't actually expect anything else here. But as you can see, he caught me off guard and still did a pretty respectable amount of damage. Anyway, let's check the grills here. Just another tin can and a pressure cooker. I wonder if I can hit him from here. Doesn't look like it. You've discovered F. Scott Key Trail and Campground. Here he comes. There. That could have been ugly, but we're good now. There you go. There's your first Deathclaw. Take his hand. The Deathclaw Gauntlet is a phenomenal weapon. I'll actually probably replace Fisto with it. Scrap metal, 2 sensor modules, and schematics, Deathclaw Gauntlet. What do you know? At a workbench, combine Wonder Glue, Leather Belt, Medical Brace, Deathclaw Hand. With this weapon, your unarmed attacks will have the ferocity and armor-shredding power of the Deathclaws, assuming you can survive long enough to take one of their hands, of course. I got a metal box here with a Nuka-Cola. I could sleep, but I'm heading back to my house anyway to make a Deathclaw Gauntlet, since I can. Tin can, tin can. First aid box, bobby pin, dirty water stim pack. Iguana on a stick. Alright. That's it for the F. Scott Key Trail and Campground. Let's pop back to Megaton. Fisto, we hardly knew ye. Actually, it served us very well.
How may I serve you, Mom?
Let me grab out. Let me put away the fission battery, motorcycle gas tank, handbrake, pressure cooker, 2 sensor modules, and 12 tin cans. I have the Deathclaw hand, so let's take out 1 leather belt, 1 medical brace, and 1 wonder glue. There you go. Alright. Deathclaw Gauntlet. Now, you'll note it doesn't do as much raw damage as Fisto does. 30, 34. Of course, it's in worse shape. And it weighs more, but the big deal with the Deathclaw Gauntlet is it completely ignores damage resistance. So, goodbye, Fisto. you've served us well, that your purpose is served. I don't have any explosives. Plus, it just looks really cool. Almost like Freddy Krueger. Heal, restore, remove. Let's put that Nuka-Cola away. Moira's still open, that's good. Sell a little bit of stuff to her. And do a little offloading.
Oh, hey!
Or repairing, not offloading. There we go. Okay, let's sell her the dirty water, Yao Guai meat. There's some things here I just no longer need to carry around. I'm looking at the 10mm sub, I'm looking at the scoped 44 Magnum. And I'm thinking, yeah, pretty much time for them to go. I will hold on to that, and that, and that, and that. And those. And all those.
Good hunting!
Good. Deathclaw Gauntlet, combat armor, dart gun. Let's see what that little bit of repair work did to my damage. Oh, it stayed at 30. That's alright, though. Alright, let's pop back to the F. Scott Key Trail and Campground. Way over in the southwest corner. From here, you can see it. It looks ominous. It's a very creepy dungeon. Like I always say, somebody at Bethesda is a fan of H.P. Lovecraft, and the Dunwich building is the level they got to build. Just watch this. That is the power of ignoring armor. Less raw damage, and yet, we popped him in 2 hits instead of the usual 3. Have discovered Dunwich building. It could be Dunwich, but anyway, it's a big, involved 3-area dungeon, at the end of which, story-driven, at the end of which we'll be rewarded with the melee weapon Bobblehead. Could also be extremely difficult if you have broken steel installed and you're high enough, and you're leveled enough to face feral ghoul reavers. In here at level 12, I shouldn't have to fight anything more powerful than the first one. Good night. Also notice the much higher critical rate with the Deathclaw Gauntlet. Has a higher critical chance than your power fists did. I adore this weapon. In we go. Here's the Dunwich building. We got a couple of grenade boxes right off the bat, or a grenade box and an ammo box. That's good. Let's start here on the left. Tin can, and we have Jamie's personal entry. 1. Jamie's personal journal, entry 1.
Why the hell would he come all the way out here? Dad's been a little nuts for some time now, but not like this. Leaving me in that crappy old hospital without waking me, without a goddamn flashlight. I made enough selling the meds we scrounged to have kept us both fed at the colony for weeks. Now I'm almost out of rations, my shoes are pretty much destroyed, and I'm still chasing the old coot. By my last reckoning, he was headed south.
Jamie's personal journal entry, too.
Maybe I shouldn't have waited so damn long to start tracking him. Trail's gone cold. Gonna wander with these guys a while. They say they wander the area. Maybe somebody's seen Dad.
Jamie's personal journal entry 3.
These guys aren't who I thought they were. Jesus, they killed that family for a sack of rotten vegetables. Getting out of here next chance I can without catching a bullet.
Jamie's personal journal entry 4.
Hit a caravan today. Trev didn't see the kid and got popped. I took care of Tawny right then and put one in Thor before he saw her fall. That earned me some grub from the traders. Even better, they saw Dad. He was in pretty rough shape and still has the goddamn book. Trader says it gave him the creeps. Me too. But it's good to know he's still alive. Still headed south.
Jamie's personal journal entry 5.
He must have been trying to trap food here. I recognize his snares. I can make out a building on the horizon. That must be where he headed. If not, at least I get a roof tonight.
Inside the Edotronic, there are 3 stim packs. Vending machine with a Nuka-Cola, always nice. It's very dark in the Dunwich building. You kind of have to use your Pip-Boy light just to navigate. But you have to be careful, because you don't want to alert the feral ghouls. So, let's head through this door to the left. Roamer and a standard. Sneak crit the roamer. One shot the standard. I'll take his med X. I'll take his pre-war money. Now I can loot this first room. Not there's apparently anything in here. Let's check this one. Still nothing. Check back here. Empty desk, a lot of corpses, empty desk, empty filing cabinets. Over here, got empty desk, empty filing cabinets, vacuum cleaner, empty filing cabinets, empty desk, staticky radio, Jamie's personal journal entry 6.
Don't like the look of this place. Don't like the smell. Gives me the creeps. Don't want to risk a shot at the crows till I know what's in there. Sneaking in tonight.
And a couple more empty filing cabinets. Start sneaking again. I can hear another ghoul close by and I can see 2 red hash marks. Go in here. Bam. With him gone, let's hang a left and check out this little storage room. Got an assault rifle in crummy shape. We got 2 clips of assault rifle ammo. Grenade box, 4 frag grenades. Easy locked ammo box. Fire hose nozzle. Mine box, 3 frag mines. Nuka-Cola Quantum. Mine box with 4 frag mines. It's a productive little room, I must say. And now we can head up the stairs. stay out of that big open room for now. See one down there. Just another roamer. Three bottle caps. Alright, boss. Let's head into the small room. Or smaller rooms. We got a pack of cigarettes in the desk. Empty filing cabinets. Another entrance back to that hallway. Empty desk, empty filing cabinet. Nothing on the desk. What's back here? Oh, we're back in the hallway. Notice that the door shut behind me without me shutting it. Get a couple Nuka-Colas out of that vending machine. And now let's head into this big main office. Can't disarm the rigged terminal. Just leave it be. The desks are empty. See the hash marks, but ah, there he is.
Ha!
Damn! He's spotted. Take his pack of cigarettes and pencil. The other one is underneath. Oh, he was underneath me, but now he's over here. Come here, bro. He's pretty standard. Take his bottle cap. Make sure I check all these desks. Pack of cigarettes and Wonder Glue in that one. Those are empty. Also need to be careful not to fall. I want to be systematic about this. Empty. Empty. This one has three bottle caps in it. And there's a glowing one. Now let's sneak crit him with the death claw gun. There he goes. Take the red pass card and the pack of cigarettes. There is an actual staircase leading down. Check that out in a minute, but first... empty desk. This hallway seems clear. Is that everything? I find it a little hard to believe that's everything, but I guess it could be. That room's empty. In here. An empty desk, and another rigged terminal. Alright, I guess that is everything. Let's head down the stairs, then. Need to keep searching this room. And I'm getting a phone call, so let me pause the recording. And we're back. Sorry for the interruption. Let's just keep looking around for now. This room seems completely empty. Let's just go through the other door. We have a desk with some pre-war money. Desk with more pre-war money. Jamie's personal journal, entry 7.
Raiders told spook stories about zombies in the ruins. Never saw anything like that where I come from. Lord help me. They're real. Not quite what Thor said, but close. These things look... I think they really used to be people.
Empty desk. There's an empty syringe. And a scalpel. We'll head to Area 2, the forsaken Dunwich ruins. Head up these stairs. Move forward. And something interesting will happen here. A strange little flashback. To before things went so terribly awry. I'll gladly sneak crit that glowing one. Check all these desks, they all seem empty, as does the filing cabinet behind them. There's a Jamie's personal journal entry 8.
God help me. I found Dad today. I didn't think it was him, but face. The zombies didn't touch him. I think he was becoming like them. Didn't know it was him until I found that old book near him. No more killing. I just need to go. Can't forget the book. All I have left of him. It's warm against the stone. I'll just rest a while.
Uh-oh. An easy locked terminal. Let's get it open. Parties, 3 of 7. Parties 2. Parties 1. Parties 1. Parties 1. Parties 3. There we go. That one was easy. Welcome, Herman Granger. Available records in memory. Ah, Dunwich Borers, LLC. Auto-dictation software. 2074 PagSoft. About auto-dictation software. Software version is V223, configured to user voice H. Granger. Onomatopoeia detection, dictation is off. Phonetic spelling parser is off. Autocorrect on. 10-18-2077. Before the war. Coughing. Memo to sales staff. In recognition of an exemplary quarter, Mr. Statham has authorized me to release sales staff early for the holidays. Unintelligible. It was no easy task to release a new acoustic borer to a market used to conventional bit bore drilling systems, but thanks your hard work and unintelligible, acoustic bore drills are setting a new standard in the excavation industry. Coughing. Thanks to your many private sales and procurement of government contracts, we'll all be in the black for the foreseeable future. Happy holidays from Mr. Statham and Dunwich Borers. Now get home to your families. Applause. 10-23-2077. Unintelligible. Boom. Unintelligible. Notice to user. PagSoft LLC recommends against sustained recordings in a low-frequency environment. Continued use in this manner voids all hardware warranties. Auto-dictator V223 powering off automatically. 10-23-2077. Unintelligible. Unintelligible. Notice to user. PagSoft LLC recommends against sustained recordings in a low-frequency environment. Continued use in this manner voids all hardware warranties. Auto-dictator V223 powering off automatically. That would be the day the bombs fell, obviously. 3-27-21-34. Unintelligible. What the hell was that? Doesn't matter, doesn't matter. Deep breathing. Where is it? Where? Impact sound. Paper crumple. There. Paper crumple. Safe and sound. Jesus, they bled so much, but I kept it clean. Clean. Unintelligible. Shit, more. Got to move. Got to keep it safe. 4-27-21-34. Deep breathing. My skin. Barely any left. One of them now, but they know I still have it. Stay back. Back, you! Deep breathing. That's close enough. Door. You and you too. Over there. Yes. One of us. Ugqualtoth is returned. Unintelligible. 5-1-21-34. Liquid dripping. Qualtoth, unintelligible. Qualtoth, I came. Back this time. Deep temple, unintelligible. Screaming, twisting, unintelligible. Impact sound. No light, no flesh, unintelligible. Deep temple born, deep temple died. Qualtoth again, unintelligible. Returned, unintelligible. Retribution. Notice to user, internal memory capacity reached. Pagsoft LLC recommends Pagmem LLC for all your data storage needs. Please contact your administrator for details. That was almost 150 years ago. So, definitely something up here. As if that wasn't obvious. So we got a few possible exits. We can go up that ramp. I prefer the door. Up these stairs. Creep through this hallway. Kill that guy. Five bottle caps. Check this little room. Then turn my light on. I should be alone in here. We've got tin can, three turpentine, two Abraxo, a vacuum cleaner, toolbox with a paint gun and wonder glue, and a copy of Dean's Electronics. Repair up by 2 to 64. Delightful. We got two tin cans and a paint gun on the top shelf, and a first aid box with a blood pack and two stim packs. Very nice little room. Let's head this way. Let's take this guy out. Search him. Four bottle caps. I got two more roamers hanging out up here. Kill both of them. Search them both. Six caps. Seven caps. You'll notice we're now on the top level of the room with the ramp. Both of these, all of these really just kind of make their way in and around the same area, but uh-oh. I didn't want to do that. Where we were. Take it nice and slow and careful, and empty filing cabinet, empty desk. Wanted to hop over here. Empty. Nothing over here. This is where we could have come up the ramp. Let's search the rest of this big open space. That, I think, is the way forward. Let's check this door first. Average locked. No problem with our lockpick abilities. This room seems isolated enough. Seven bottle caps, very good. A skeleton. Bookshelf. Here we go, ammo boxes. This one's locked very easy. Get it open. That one's unlocked. Grenade box is unlocked. a Chinese assault rifle, which I'll take with me, dirty water and a stim pack in the first aid box, two bottle caps in the filing cabinet, and a very easy lock on this terminal. Trite. Ah, first one. Awesome. Dunwich Boers LLC, data entry. Here I am, trapped in a room by myself, typing on a terminal, trying to keep myself busy. Hell, trying to keep myself sane. I don't know what it is about this place, but I want to get out of here. Yeah, get out of here. I can't even bring myself to open that damn door again. I hear those things wandering around outside, sniffing, screaming, doing whatever they do. When I first got here, I thought the place was abandoned, and went around looking for anything to scavenge. 5 minutes later, I'm in this room, scared half out of my mind. Things started chasing me. I fired a few shots, missed, and ran through the darkness. Ah, shit. Told old Billy to meet me here and to bring some extra ammo and grenades. That was 3 days ago. Poor guy probably didn't make it too far. Those things better have given him a quick death. Listen to me, babbling like a damn fool. Billy's all right. I'll just stick here until those things go away and meet up with him. Ha, what a story I have for him. All right, well. Let's turn our Pip-Boy light off. I think we're gonna get back into populated areas as we go this way. Yes, I see more ghouls. Along with a lot of holes in the floor. Pop that one. Get his two caps. Stay on the top level if I can. Just check everything out without falling down. It's tough, of course, but I think it is doable. There's an actual staircase. Assume the way I'm intended to go down if I don't fall. Take that pre-war money. And get back to scattering around up here. That one is the spot where you just have to make a jump, I think. And then full on spotted. That means I can stop sneaking. Let's check over here. A whole lot of nothing. Let's just go jump into that bathroom. And then we can go downstairs. Ah, good. Well, we got a leather belt. Got some jet in the toilet. Apparently that's it. Let's get back to the stairs. Let's head down. There's the door to Area 3, the virulent underchambers. Let's take care of everybody down here first. Make sure we've fully explored everything. Everybody, so I'll take his ammo, I'll take his med-X, And I'll take his bottle caps. Now, is there anything else going on down here? Oh. Just another ghoul. Who we will kill. With great prejudice. Search him, I'll take his bobby pin and his ammo. Head over to the virulent underchamber's door. And pause again. Not so much because I'm worried about desync, but I'm being interrupted in real life, so I will be right back. Thank you for your patience. And we're back once again. Let's head into Area 3, the virulent underchambers. Now, this one, the only way to progress is to fall through the holes in the floor. Be careful doing that. There are multiple levels and you don't want to skip any. Because there are things to find on all of them. Jamie's personal journal, entry 9.
Sharp knife. Sharp knife to send him to Deep Temple. Flay and say my words. Abdul comes again on the feast of the weaker. Feast for the Deep Temple. Born again. Here. Alhazared! Yet! Yet!
Alright. There you go. This desk has something in it. I'll take that dart. How about this corner? Whole lot of nothing. Let's drop to level 2. Notice that we start taking rads. So let's try not to hang out too long. That one has some bottle caps. Level 3, we have a first aid box, 2 blood packs, purified water, stim pack, and a fire hose nozzle in the fire hose box. And let's go down to the bottom. Feral ghoul there. Standard flavor, also known as easy flavor. Here's a rope. Should be an easy kill. The infirmary at home. I'm gonna go ahead and pop one rat away just because we're getting dangerously close to minor radiation poisoning. Let's head down. Another first aid box, Rad-X and Stimpak. Another fire hose box, complete with fire hose nozzle. We can continue on. As we get into this room, there's a staircase going up and a door. Take the door first. Take out another roamer. Take his carton of cigarettes and his metro ticket. I hope you heard the ambient noise there. The whispering. This doesn't happen anywhere else in the game. There's the standard one.
Ha!
Successfully sneak into here. So, I took out one standard. Let's take out that one there.
Where? Ah, that's it.
That's Jamie. Gain karma for killing him because he's very evil. Alright. Four ferals. Five ferals. And Jamie himself. Four ferals. Three ferals. Two ferals. One feral. Alright. That's all the ferals. Now let's search Jamie. Got a Chinese assault rifle. We'll take that out with us. And here must be the Deep Temple. Now that's certainly unnerving. I think that's everything for this room. Ah, no. Ammo box is good. We've got an easy lock. Let's pop it open. These are all unlocked. That's all well and good. And we can head back to the stairs. The Point Lookout expansion added a quest that requires us to do something with that obelisk. So much, much, much later, we will be back here. By then we'll have a Chinese stealth armor so we can just sneak through everything. But if you're playing vanilla Fallout 3, you never have any reason to come back. So, let's head through that door. Note what we have here. Tin can, tin can, tin can, tin can, and the bobblehead melee weapons. The inscription on the base reads, "It's important to do business up close and personal. Your melee weapon's skill has been permanently increased by 10 points. And there's an actual Nuka-Cola. Melee weapons is now at 42. Awesome. And let's head through this door to the Dunwich building. We're in a ceiling area above the, or an upper floor of the very first office we explored. Let's make sure we search the desks up here before we drop down. And let's head out. That's it for the Dunwich building. Let's head back to Megaton and offload.
Welcome home, sir.
Start here. Drop off a Braxo, fire hose nozzles, leather belt, paint guns, rad scorpion glands, tin cans, turpentine, vacuum cleaners, wonder glue, and Nuka-Colas. Let's drop off our melee weapons bobblehead. I didn't find anything unique. I got a lot of explosives in there, which is pretty cool. Let's drop those. Let's head upstairs. Drop the two Chinese assault rifles, which would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Drop the Nuka-Cola Quantum, 13 more. that's everything. Awesome. Let's hit the My First Infirmary. And let's go visit Moira. Sell off some of this gear. And repair the stuff we're wearing. You know, the usual drill.
So, are they intelligent?
Good, good, good. Dirty water, jet, MedX, Galguai meat, carton of cigarettes, ticket, packs of cigarettes, pencils, pre-war money, red pass card, 32 caliber rounds, 10 millimeter rounds. Very good. I don't think I'm gonna ever use the railway rifle either. So I can sell her my railway spikes.
Good hunting! And
let's repair my stuff. Next target will be the Bobblehead explosives. That's up here in the northwest, actually pretty close to some stuff we already explored. I'm going to fast travel to SATCOM Array Northwest 7C. I'm going to note that the... with some chagrin that the Enclave soldier has respawned. And this time he's got a plasma rifle. And he's got Tesla armor. But it's nothing to a man with a Deathclaw gauntlet. You'll notice that the Tesla armor doesn't have any downsides. Energy weapons plus 10, rad resistance plus 20. But we still can't use it, and it's still too heavy to be worth selling. Plasma rifle is a different story. That'll take a heartbeat as I drop a blowfly. And enjoy the fact the SATCOM tower is clear once again. I'm gonna leave it here. This has been Let's Play Fallout 3. We successfully made it to and cleared the Dunwich building and acquired the Bobblehead melee weapons. Next time, we'll head over to WKML Broadcast Station for the Bobblehead explosives. Until then, thank you very much for watching, and have a fantastic night.